Now I'm equipped, as you see, I'm equipped also here with this photo to make snapshots when I come to organizations, and with mobile to be efficient in communication, so I go and communicate directly. And my job is to go to organizations and help by using my experience as IT manager. So don't hate me, because I was IT guy. I programmed on calculators, on paper, in the end of 80s, and then worked through a couple of companies. Topic. I will share a practical case. I promised to share a practical case from one company in Russia, where Kanban was given as a tool for IT management to find the resources, to find time to work on improvements. So I hope it will work not only for big companies, but also you, in the smaller companies, you will see possibility to apply same principles. Okay? You can ask questions immediately, yes, that would be better. Quickly, I want to understand also, because I'm from project management area. I'm in project management association, in the board of International Project Management Association in Latvia. So we do certifications, we do different stuff. I want to know, who are project managers? Okay. Who are certified project managers? Great. Who have studied project management? bigger. So I'm teaching masters in Riseba to program and portfolio management. What else? I can tell. I could share some examples also from retail, because I was CIO. This title, career is over. In retail chain, drogas, because I prepared them for acquisition by Chinese company and then stayed to implement Chinese governance. That's horrible. But actually, when you go to drogas store, and see on the cash point, cash desk, some fancy technologies, that's the result of work. I could also share with you some telecom experience, because of what telecom work as a project manager, developing new products and services, and also in Teleton, developing shared service center in Riga, and half year spending in Kazakhstan, helping to integrate newly acquired operator. But the case I want to share is from insurance industry in Russia. That's top 10 company. But actually, the issue they have is like this. Do you recognize what it is? The product? I take guesses.
Gum.
Things
yes.
We don't have time for.
That's a gum, chewing gum. So that's a product for once for very busy people who don't have time. When you don't have time, you become inventive. You go into time management courses, but it doesn't help usually, and you start to invent things like chewing gum instead of giving you time. Yourself time to brush teeth. And the companies also have the same directions usually. They go into this vicious cycle. No time to work on improvements, and they invent some workarounds and then things. And people in operations say they feel like this. We do implement workaround, which is temporarily, but it stays forever. Then they do some another workaround and more workaround and don't have time to work on technical depth. And it becomes very hard to be productive, especially in operations. And but this can be seen also that managers are busy. You cannot catch them. They hide in the boardrooms. The company was quite big, more than 100 employees, more than $10 million IT budget, but they have branches in the regions. They have multiple help desks. That's quite common, right? Who have one help desk for the whole company? Applause. Not many, but that's a direction where the company is looking for. But reality that
the reality many suck a lot.
Many, multiple help desks, and the maturity level. Who is familiar with CMMI? Perfect. And who is CMMI 0? No? CMMI 1? CMMI 2? 3? 4? 5?
No, 5.
Yeah.
5 is less.
That's correct. But the issue usually is the overall maturity of organization. It's not only the people. And they don't have SLAs with businesses, and that's pretty bad, because business expects something and they get something and they are not happy with it, because there is no prior agreement. Can I draw something in project management? Everyone knows the triangle most like, right? Project management. Time. Not here. Costs. Not here.
Quality.
Scope. Quality. Scope. That's right. And if you want to satisfy your customer, where you put the SLA? Here? Delivery in time.
Just like on the slide.
So that's about money as well.
Money? Maybe. But what about quality? They don't expect you to deliver shit.
SLA is inside.
Here. You're a maximalist. So that's when you are young, then you think that the ideal solution is possible. No, it's not. The solution is somewhere in between. You shall cut your services into molecular, small number of things and agree separately for each separate molecular service, which is more optimal for the business. Then, on overall, you get satisfaction. Do you know how to find out if customer is satisfied? What question would you ask? Are you happy? That's one. More question? More?
Will you purchase more?
Will you
purchase more?
That's pretty close to the ideal question.
Will you recommend me?
Thank you. Applause. Would you recommend? That's exactly the question that gives a more precise idea if customer is satisfied. But let's go back to the situation in the company I'm telling about. And actually, that was how I understood the management is feeling. They perhaps see that they are quite experienced and smart guys. Foresee if things would continue the same direction, there will be, in no matter of time, talks about outsourcing the whole IT. Someone. And this thing, which is called ITIL and IT service management on the broader scale, is perhaps the answer, but it can be very scary to the companies who want to implement them if they don't find the way to adopt and adapt these things. Because I have went through this ITIL intermediate certifications. And do they expect everyone to read these five books, more than 500 pages each book, and then somehow bring to everybody and say, we will work by this? It's possible, but nowadays nobody believes it's very realistic. It was somewhere in the 90s when companies wanted to use some maybe budgets and then sell some trainings and books. Now companies want real results from this. And here is the knowledge in ITIL. It's a framework which accumulated the knowledge of consultancy for over 30 years at least. And how to apply, how to adopt. The answer is there was first Agilist. Do you know the cycle? What's this? Deming cycle. You're a little bit wrong. It's the handwriting of Deming. Do you see how he puts the name? Schuchart. That's a Schuchart cycle. It's Deming's mentor. Deming was successful in marketing. He marketed this invention very well. Maybe not well, very well in Japan, but in US he was not so successful initially. Nothing new to many of us, especially so interested in Agile. The cycle that you plan things, then you carry it out and study what is the outcome. And then you, if it's a change in IT service management program, it's usually a change, improvement, then you think, will we adopt it to organization? Will we stop this? Or will we try to do it in different conditions? So remember, Schuchart. One step to go for is to collect everybody, stakeholder analysis, and project management, that's one of the very important steps. Well, that's a typical Russian meeting. When you ask someone, could we sit down and chat about your function, and then he comes with 20 people. when you do stakeholder analysis, then you shall understand who are the key players. That means they have high influence and also high interest. And then what you do with them, you manage them, you keep your eye on them all the time. Important people. What you do with them, they don't have so high interest, not on daily basis. You keep them satisfied. Affected. They don't have influence, but they are very interested. Perhaps that will their job depends on that. And then you keep them informed. The others, you monitor. That's pretty what we have done when stepped in this organization, understood who are stakeholders, because that's a very dangerous thing. Keep someone from this or this quadrant not informed even about the project. Then, how to adopt using the Schufert cycle? You don't need to set up a big project, a program with many people changing roles. You just get your information from people. You divide into typical IT terminology, the areas, where they see the issues. They know better than you what are the issues. And when you involve, that creates engagement. That means we are more enthusiastic about things that we change. We don't like being changed. Yeah? And actually, when people feel that management is serious about changing things, then they give good ideas, despite the feeling that maybe if I give it, then I will have to work on it. But still, we want to behave well. That's then as expert, or you might have many experts on the area, they put comments and priority. And then you can start working with it, but you need management commitment. So the final priority is approved by CIO in this case. So that's how we did to make sure that there were no discussions, maybe we don't have to do it, etc. And also that's very good from the side that if CIO tells yes it's important, then he also will give you time somehow. He commits to giving you time. And the project of IT implementing IT service management, the outcome is roadmap, is a strategic plan about how to go along this journey towards business and IT alignment. That's a good while you're working on this big picture, don't forget to about this priority list. You have it. Why not starting to implementing small things immediately? If possible, the day you have got the ideas, you see what are quick wins. Maybe I can deliver already this evening something. Someone have forgot the promise from management to employees, and you can say, let's deliver. In this way, you build up credibility. So people say, we started to get something. It worked in the environment of this insurance company pretty well, because already in first evening and second day we knew which small things, the old promises we start to deliver from the management team. Also this part, implement top priorities, is important. It's from Agile. You work, you draw the red line and you work on the most important things. And if many projects of IT service management fall into it, in this trap of analysis paralysis, they start to work on business problem, qualified needs and planning, etc., and they don't deliver anything. And that's seen. What you need to do is again to deliver something. This was a Kanban board that we installed in the room of IT management of that company, which was pretty simple, quite empty initially. But you start small. You put something, and that's also a sign for everybody who comes into management to ask for a salary. So, they do something on improvements, they have plan, what we have here, it's a backlog of things. It can be very high level initially, but then we decided that we need to give a lot of space to decomposition of this high level goals. And also invented one thing, which is, for, I think, specifically for IT service management. Formulation of why we do things. Because just what we do, not always clearly says to everybody and gives same understanding what is the goal. Different colors are different managers, different silos. So they pull the work from here when they come together from all the pile of improvements. Instead of these improvements being pushed by business or CIO to them, so we created an environment where they able to come and together agree on what improvements we will work this week. Numbers are priorities. So on the top we see higher priority, on the bottom lower priority, and we put also numbers because when it develops there is mixture. Then we have here limited capacity. Tasks that are chosen to be executed, improvement initiative, and they are approved by product owner. Initially that was CIO, later that was transferred to separate person, product owner. When it's approved, it stays, because then the managers come and they pull. We will do this. We put it in progress, done, and here the column that we later deleted because it's waste. That's effect is approved. Evidence. We have seen evidence of the effect.
But it was so evident you couldn't read the column.
They told so.
Yeah, it's the hardest part in many projects.
So the main idea of this work is to visualize that the work and on improvements, and to give possibility to the managers to have structured teamwork how they address all this.
What's the point of having priorities for these tasks? So the idea of Kanban is that you have a limited work in progress. What's the point of prioritizing this small number of items there?
Because the priorities might change, and CIO wanted to keep possibility to rearrange.
Withdraw from the Kanban board if it's not priority.
Because the number is not so small. It's up to
it's waste, I think, as well. Yes.
Maybe.
That is there.
What then? Then they started to work and to move these things. And what was important is to keep regularity. That's one. And then to make this initiative stick to organization, to make it stable, regular practice. It's a cultural change that might meet quite high resistance sometimes. And to avoid this, we agreed to work to define like the values instead of rules. So rules are more strict limitations, what and how shall we do. And values are more like offenses that gives you broader space to maneuver.
Yeah,
yes?
I have a question. How do you limit, I In Kanban, you have to define like one task or two tasks on a lane for a team or a developer. How do you limit in this case? Because I didn't understand from this picture. Very important.
Не более двух задач на человека. So managers agree.
So one line is a one man or one developer?
One color is a one lead of IT direction. Like operations manager, infrastructure manager.
So when they move these tasks from different positions to the next, they are picking another red color. It's, note and then rewriting the task.
That's the process. Well, yeah. There is a. I will tell what kind of regular activities we have agreed on. And one was regular meetings where they come together and they work on decomposing these things into similar size chunks of work.
May I give you one comment?
Yes.
So is it can you bring back? Sorry.
Here.
So here, basically, most of the screen is taking a backlog. And if we apply something like a Scrum, first one is a backlog. Second is a Scrum called sprint backlog. It's like you do a decomposition of a big item to a small one. And then the next picture, please.
Yes.
The next one, your process is. Start here, but I don't see a limit. I don't understand how it was limited. So the idea of Kanban is to limit for the team or a person, limit at least one or two tasks.
Mm-hmm.
Here, I just simply don't understand what was the limit applied or not.
Two colors, two things of one color.
Yeah, you can see it's three. Three green, three orange.
No, it's red.
Okay.
And the green one, that's where they have discussed a lot, and the person who have green have told, no, I will do three things. I want to do three things this time. And they told, okay, you do three things, but our limit is two. You do it three, we do it two. You know, for this case, when team just started, it's not important, not so critical what is the number, while team understands, explores its capacity. When they are working already for quite a time, then they can stick to the same work number of tasks. When they started, they might agree next day, no. Now we increase the work influence.
This board is managing how many people? There are two workers and managers or?
Now, this is a board for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, eight colors, 8 managers in the IT management.
So the process there are, if that is red and that one is orange, then it's three people working.
Different color is
the rest
different.
Are like waiting their assignments.
Yes. So, let's continue. And I wanted to give examples of the values that we defined on a list of A4 paper. And have put it on in the corner of this world. So they have these values they committed to follow in front of them. Why again we need to manage by values instead of rules? This Colin Power have told that commander in the field is always right and rear echelon is not, unless proven otherwise. So that means that the guys who manage their silo in IT know better what is a more precise and effective way to do the task. One of the value is participate and bring ideas. So they have a backlog and everybody shall top up the backlog. Second is participation. And participation, that's the regular weekly meetings they have scheduled for half year. Same time, same place, same management room. And three things always have been told by everybody. What is done in their area, what they plan next week, and what they need help with. From the team or product owner, CIO, remove barriers. Issue with a business, with big bosses. Also, one of the value, to share ownership. The product owner can come and change priorities, but does not micromanage. The team itself agrees in these meetings which priority is higher and which priority needs to be changed. So, one more thing is everybody shall be fair to other teammates. And if you define in the backlog a task, improvement, that will be just for one day work and others will take for 1 week, it will not be fair. So the decomposition of the tasks, they shall learn to decompose to the tasks that are not too big, not too small, but are enough to work within a week and can be done within a week. And the scope, they had discussion that shall we put here everyday operations things? No. We agreed to keep the scope, these improvements. We put here only improvements that are within this IT service management program. Another value they have committed, focus on making progress. That limitation of these tasks. But again, when team is new, it's not so critical and can be flexible. Another thing that is flexible, all values and rules. They can say, no, we delete this rule from our Kanban initiative and we change it. Instead of values, they also have agreed and listed on that A4 paper some lean principles. It's pretty lean direction. One lean principle, do it right the first time long ahead. Another principle, focus on what matters. Focus on what is important today. Also, talk less, more action. Always think about improvements and efficiency. Do you know the difference about efficiency and effectiveness? Efficiency is about how good you are in doing something. And I like effectiveness more. I like to work less, but produce more output, more results. That's effectiveness. Also, one principle they taken from the, it's solve the root cause instead of side effects. And this waste, fight the waste. If you see waste, you fight it. So this is why when the when we met after some months and analyzed how they worked, we came up with several improvements. One was that they wanted to minimize time they spent standing in front of the board by moving debates, discussions, separate meetings, because initially for them it was horrible. They started to discuss something and it turned out instead of Kanban meeting, strategy, IT strategy meeting or something. Strictly following agenda. So these three things: done, plan, and need help. And also avoiding wastes in communication. Some people are different in the way they explain, and some people like to repeat. You see, some people like to repeat. Second thing that they wanted to change and improve was the process, how efficient they are in decomposing the big tasks to smaller. They agreed that they need specifically think before the meeting the definitions of these decomposed tasks. So they not come and start thinking how to name it correctly so it is not too big, not too small. They come already with a list where the proposals are ready. And to make it work, they agreed that no, we add to the backlog anytime. We don't wait for a meeting. If I'm here during the night and I'm solving the data center outage issue, then I put something. Also, some culture thing. PC phone. They are managers. Bosses, and they used to work with telephone very much, too much. So they get interrupted during the meeting. So they agreed to no matter what, phone and PC is a way to keep our time tight during the meeting. They deleted the column about effect that is approved by business. Maybe later they will bring it back. And the culture thing, people don't like to complain. So they actually had a very this honest discussion that no, I'm CIO, you are my mentor, my employee, but I will not blame you if you bring problems to me. When you answer this done, planned, and what help you need with, tell honestly if you need help. Because if you don't ask, it stays somewhere anyway. So what were the results of the implementation? They had some time, money left to buy normal hardware. Because they didn't need to employ costly consultants to run the actual program. Program managers, project managers, whatsoever. They just needed one to kick it off. So that was one of the results. And recently we had a telephone call and they confirmed that that stays, and that's their usual daily practice. What else? They quite quickly started to deliver practical things, and they became better on keeping the promise. Because when someone have complained something, they just drop a note in the backlog. It stays there, and there comes time and they pick it up, pull it. Because one of the reasons why managers forget to do things, not because they are lazy or they don't want, because they are too overwhelmed with information, with requests, and not everyone is very good in prioritizing. What is time? How much time do we have?
Well, we spent about half time we had. So, thanks for the first. It was very interesting.
It's not finished yet.
Yeah. Then, well, we can spend, say, 5-10 more minutes and then have a break. And
that's,
then we better be.
That's the plan.
Yep.
Then I will not go directly to explaining what is here. But I will tell that these are clickable links. When you click, you see what is behind. And what is behind is materials created by Matthias Skerin, right, from Greece, one of the very good specialists in Kanban applied. David Anderson is also good. Matthias has co-authored this book. And if you are in operations, you click here. Introducing Kanban in operations. That's exactly the answers you need. If you are trying and feel that you're making mistakes, perhaps you could look on the mistakes others have made already and learn from them. And here, I will click its examples of.
No, it's Windows. Fresh Windows.
Yeah. Never mind. It's example of different Kanban boards. Kanban boards can be applied not only in ITSM. ITSM, that's a strange application. It's more often can be seen in operations, in development, but also there are examples how it can be applied to marketing, to sales. So it's, and depends based on your team specific. It's a different design. But one thing don't forget, design is not fixed. Kanban gives you freedom to experiment. And for this ITSM, we have experimented really, not taken for something. So let's experiment and share the experiments. I do it regularly through my Twitter, so I need followers badly. So if you want to hear something from project management and how Kanban also can be applied, then please follow and you will hear from me. Thank you very much. There are some parts that contacts, I will put it here. Please come and ask questions afterwards. But maybe a few questions immediately, and then we have a break. Yes?
Just one more question. So what is the best size of one single job for this Kanban? And the second one, is this Kanban, it is only for project management, this is not for developers itself.
Okay, I will answer both questions. First question was about what is optimal size. Size, that's a chunk of work that fits your cycle. If your cycle is 1 day, then it shall fit your 1 day. If it's a week, for the management team, not the project managers, and it was 1 week. So they agreed to week weekly. So that was the size of the task that the manager can take, delegate, or together with their team, deliver that improvement in the area within a week. Okay. More questions? Then agree. Okay, you deserve it.